There are three measures of central tendency: the mean, the median, and the mode. Let's begin with the mode. The mode is the most frequently occurring score. The mode would then be the score with the highest frequency. If there is one most frequently occurring score, one mode, we call that a unimodal distribution. A unimodal distribution has only one major peak. Now, in other cases, there may be two modes. A bimodal distribution has two major peaks. The mode is most commonly used with nominal level data, when there's one category that is likely to be the most popular. When a distribution is bimodal, typically it's for one of two reasons. Now first, there really may be two modes. For example, if you plot the number of fish caught by fishermen, we see a peak in the morning at dawn and another peak in the evening at dusk. In the middle of the day, when the sun is at its height, fewer fish are caught. This would be a true bimodal distribution. The second time that you see a bimodal distribution is when there are actually two distributions overlapping each other. If we compare average IQ scores from a state university and a community college, and we find a bimodal distribution, we might want to split our data by school to see if we are really dealing with two distinct distributions of scores. Because they are two different groups, you should separate them before analyzing the dataset. The mode is most commonly used with nominal data. So for example, if we took a poll of a class asking, "What flavor of ice cream do you prefer?" One flavor would be the most popular. That most frequently chosen flavor would be the mode. To calculate the mode, it is very useful, although not absolutely necessary, to arrange the scores in ascending order from lowest to highest to see which score occurs most frequently. So look at the values in dataset A and see if you can figure out the mode. There are more fours than any other number, so the mode is 4. It is the most frequently occurring score. Now look at dataset B. What is the mode? You'll see there are actually two most frequently occurring scores, 5 and 9. So this is a bimodal distribution with modes at 5 and 9. Incidentally, when you get the mode in SPSS and the distribution is bimodal, SPSS will tell you the smallest mode, in this case it would be 5, and then give you a warning that multiple modes exist. The measure of central tendency that you choose to report depends upon your data, so it is important to know when you should choose the mode instead of the mean or the median. The biggest advantage of the mode is that it is not susceptible to outliers at all. Any outlier, no matter how large, has absolutely no effect on the mode. Remember that an outlier is a score that is significantly higher or lower than most of the other scores. The advantage to the mode is also its disadvantage. The mode ignores most of the data by not considering scores other than the most frequent. So for example, if the scores were 7, 7, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, the mode is 7, but that mode of 7 is misleading because most of the scores are not around 7. The 7 is non-representative. The median of 21 would be a more representative score. Another disadvantage to the mode is that it's not terribly useful when the most common score for a behavior being measured is 0. So how many cigars have you smoked in the last month? There may be 2 people in class who have smoked a cigar, but our mode of 0 doesn't tell us anything about those people of interest. You should report the mode when there is one particular score that dominates the distribution. This occurs with nominal level data, such as when we want to know the most popular category or the most commonly selected product. Report the mode when the distribution is bimodal, when the mean or the median would be non-representative. The mode is the central tendency measure of choice when the variables are measured at the nominal level. Nominal level variables will be analyzed using a non-parametric test. And finally, The mode can be a quick and easy way to get a sense of your ordinal or scale variables when you are first approaching a dataset.